Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be going over bulk transport through the cell membrane through the processes of endocytosis and exocytosis. Both endocytosis and exocytosis involve materials being contained within vesicles. These vesicles either bind and become part of the cell membrane or form from and break off from the cell membrane. This is possible because of the fluid and flexible nature of the cell membrane. The cell membrane is made up of phospholipids that are held together by their weak associations of the hydrophobic fatty acid tails, creating a bilayer. These weak associations allow for the membrane to be broken and reformed, allowing endocytosis and exocytosis to occur. Endocytosis and exocytosis are both forms of bulk transport, which is important as they allow larger materials to enter and exit the cell, as they are not able to pass directly through the cell membrane or through transport proteins in the membrane. The processes of endocytosis and exocytosis both require the expenditure of energy in the form of ATP. Endocytosis is the process where molecules are transported into the cell by the molecules being engulfed into vesicles made from the cell membrane. The first step of endocytosis involves the material that is going to be engulfed moving closer to the cell membrane. The second step involves the membrane creating a depression surrounding the material. The depression eventually seals and buds off, creating a completely enclosed vesicle that contains the molecules now inside the cell. The outer layer of the cell membrane becomes the inner layer of the vesicle. The inner layer of the cell membrane becomes the outer layer of the vesicle. This vesicle is now able to move through the cytoplasm. There are three main forms of endocytosis. Phagocytosis is a form of endocytosis that involves the cell engulfing larger substances. Pinocytosis is when the cell is engulfing liquids or substances dissolved in liquids. Receptor-mediated endocytosis is when the cell membrane has pits that are coated with proteins on the inside of the cell and receptors on the outside. The receptors bind to specific molecules outside the cell and form protein-coated vesicles inside the cell. An example of endocytosis is seen in white blood cells. They utilize the process of endocytosis to engulf pathogens to destroy them. Another example of endocytosis is seen in the single-celled organism, the amoeba. These single-celled organisms utilize the process of endocytosis to engulf food particles to get their nutrition. Exocytosis, on the other hand, is the process where molecules are transported out of the cell via vesicles that fuse with the cell membrane, releasing the contents into the extracellular space. The first step of exocytosis involves secretory vesicles from within the cell moving towards the cell membrane. The vesicle then fuses with the cell membrane. It eventually becomes part of the cell membrane, which causes the contents to be expelled into the extracellular space. An example of exocytosis is seen in the synapses of nerve cells. These cells utilize the process of exocytosis to secrete neurotransmitters out of the cell to send a chemical signal to the next nerve cell. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.